Greetings, this is Mission Control Houston, and welcome to Space Station Live. It's Friday, October 25th, 2013, and you're looking down inside of the International Space Station Flight Control Room at the Johnson Space Center in Houston, Texas. Inside the room right now, the Orbit 2 team being led by Jerry Jason, there in the brown jacket on the right side. He's the flight director for today's team. At the Capcom position right above him, two Capcoms supporting the crew today. Steve Bowen there at the top, NASA astronaut, supporting all of the ongoing spacesuit activities. And right next to him, also supporting the crew today, is Jay Marschke. On board the crew of Expedition 37, led by Russian cosmonaut Fyodor Yurchikhin there in the front row on the left. Also going across the back row, we have NASA astronaut Karen Nyberg, European astronaut Luca Parmitano, NASA astronaut Mike Hopkins, and then the two Russian cosmonauts over there on the right, Oleg Kotov and Sergei Rozhansky. Some of the major activities taking place on board the International Space Station this week, focusing on departing vehicles and also a lot of spacesuit and spacewalk preparation. Starting off with the departure of the visiting vehicle Cygnus, managed by the Orbital Sciences Corporation. It was unberthed from the Harmony module back on Tuesday at 5.05 a.m. Central Time, released from the station's robotic arm an hour and a half later at 6.31 a.m. Central, while the station was about 262 statute miles over the southern Atlantic Ocean. The craft, which was docked to the International Space Station since September 29th, when it delivered about 1,300 pounds of supplies to the crew of Expedition 37, was the final demonstration milestone of Orbital Sciences under the Commercial Resupply Commercial Orbital Transportation Services contract. That flight, which was executed flawlessly on its way to the station, again departed on Tuesday, and then a day later on Wednesday at around 12:41 p.m. Central Time, Orbital Sciences flight controllers commanded the vehicle to do a final deorbit burn and re-enter the Earth's atmosphere. On board, supporting that work this week, NASA astronaut Mike Hopkins was responsible on Monday to install the common berthing mechanism controller assembly at the hatchway, which connected Cygnus to the Earth-facing side of Harmony. He was joined in a lot of these activities on Monday by Luca Parmitano and Karen Nyberg, who were responsible not only for operating the robotic arm upon the vehicle's arrival, but also on Tuesday when they prepared to release it. Also on Monday, Luca Parmitano and Karen Nyberg doing the final closeout photos of the interior of the Cygnus vehicle before moving on and closing up the hatch for the final time. You can see a little bit of that right here as Parmitano was doing the final hatch closures, and then they conducted a few leak checks with teams on the ground. All of that, again, in preparation for that final unberthing on Tuesday, where Nyberg was responsible for configuring the robotic workstations to control the station arm, both in the Destiny Laboratory and inside the cupola for that Cygnus release and departure. She also set up the hardware command panel, which gives the crew the capability to send the unmanned cargo craft any commands during its departure phase. Parmitano and Nyberg then commanded the space station robotic arm in that release, again releasing that Cygnus vehicle, letting it depart from the International Space Station at 6:31 a.m. Central Time back on Tuesday. The other major task consuming a lot of crew time on board, both for the USOS crew and also the Russians, concerning a lot of upcoming spacewalk and also past spacewalk spacesuit maintenance with the station EMUs, or the extravehicular mobility units. Mike Hopkins and Karen Nyberg on Thursday completed a removal and replacement work on one of the fan pump separators inside one of the U.S. spacesuits. This one in particular was worn by European astronaut Luca Parmitano during his July 16th spacewalk, which was terminated prematurely once Parmitano discovered a water leak buildup inside of his helmet. Since that spacewalk, teams down here on the ground in Houston and around NASA have been analyzing the suit and building up fault trees for potential culprits. This fan pump separator, just one of the suspects that could potentially have been responsible for that water leak. So the crew on board commanded to replace that unit yesterday, and following that successful replacement yesterday, NASA astronaut Mike Hopkins is spending much of his day today doing a quick verification of that work, checking out the fan pump separator component and also how the water separator loop inside of the spacesuit is operating. So again, that work taking place on Thursday and all of the verification work being done today on Friday. Also on board the International Space Station, two Russian cosmonauts, Oleg Kotov and Sergei Rozhansky, have been preparing for an upcoming spacewalk on November 9th, where the two will exit out of the Pier's docking compartment on the Russian segment for a spacewalk, highlighted by the two taking a replica of the Olympic torch outside. You can see the spacewalk times there, that again coming up on November 9th. The two have been preparing for this, which we will be bringing you coverage of that spacewalk on NASA TV. The two preparing for this all week, starting off on Monday, gathering up a number of the tools that they'll be needing for that spacewalk and any other relevant hardware. Also gathering the spacesuits inside of the airlock for Oleg Kotov to do some configuration of the suits on Wednesday, and also with the airlock, activating and inspecting their Orlan spacesuits on Thursday. Also recharging all the water systems and batteries inside. Oleg Kotov also on Thursday doing some leak checks on the Pier's docking compartment, that again the airlock that they'll be conducting the spacewalk out of, and also checking out any of the interface equipment responsible for interacting with their suits inside of the airlock. Again, all that in preparation for an upcoming spacewalk by the two Russians, Oleg Kotov and Sergei Rozhansky, on November 9th. Other activities taking place on board the International Space Station. NASA astronaut Mike Hopkins, back on Tuesday, was gathering up some of the tools out of the Quest airlock for the Space Station EMUs. Also conducting the capillary flow experiment. You can see some quick video of that here. It's a fluid physics experiment on board the International Space Station that investigates the phenomenon known as capillary flow, which is used to transfer fluids in the absence of gravity. This is an ongoing investigation hoping to improve current models down here in the ground that are used by designers for fluid transfer systems such as fuel transfer and also other liquid transfers for experiments and crew use on board spacecraft. So having some pretty important implications in the design of future spacecraft for not only space station systems, but also long-duration flights to far-off exploration destinations. On Wednesday, Hopkins was doing some biology experiment work on his own body, collecting his vital signs, which he'll be doing throughout his increment on board the International Space Station, taking simple things like blood pressure and temperature, as these astronauts constantly have to monitor their health throughout their increments. He was also doing some extra maintenance on both suits currently inside of the Quest airlock. He was scrubbing out the cooling water loops in both those EMUs, the one of which he's been focusing on with that fan pump separator over the last 2 days. Also doing some maintenance work on the airlock itself. And then today, aside from that checkout and verification work on the spacesuit to verify all the work that he and Karen Nyberg did yesterday, Hopkins will be doing an ultrasound of his eye using the station's ultrasound system. Meanwhile, Luca Parmitano, back on Tuesday, set up the Earth Cam, or the Earth Knowledge acquired by middle school students, allowing middle school students around the world to request images of various locations of the Earth, a project that was initiated by Dr. Sally Ride, America's first woman in space. You can learn more about the Earth Cam and sign up for those missions, one of which ran all this week. They do about four per year at www.earthcam.ucsd.edu. On Wednesday, Parmitano collecting some biological samples, also performing the Skin B experiment, which looking to contribute to a better understanding of the mechanisms of skin aging, something that happens very slowly here on Earth, but is accelerated a great deal in weightlessness. So taking advantage of that microgravity environment. Parmitano also back on Thursday participating in the circadian rhythms experiment, looking to gain a better understanding of how the microgravity and the long duration spent in it affects the astronaut's sleep cycle and any effect that has on their performance and healthcare during their missions. Meanwhile, today, Luca Parmitano taking a few more biological samples and also getting ready for the departure of another unmanned cargo craft docked to the International Space Station, the European ATV-4, also known as Albert Einstein. That's set to depart, undock and depart from the aft port of the Zvezda service module after being docked for about 4 months to the orbiting complex. It delivered more than 7 tons of food, fuel, and supplies to the International Space Station residents. That undocking, which we'll be bringing you coverage here on NASA TV, currently targeted for 3:59 a.m. Central Time, 4:59 a.m. Eastern. Karen Nyberg throughout the week, focusing again on those Cygnus ops early in the week and assisting in the EMU repair. Aside from that, back on Tuesday, she was conducting the resist tubule experiment, which she's also doing today. That's a Japanese experiment taking place inside of the Japanese experiment module that looks at the mechanisms of gravity resistance in plants, something that could potentially impact the future ability of astronauts on long-duration missions to grow plants and their own food in spacecraft. Also, back on Wednesday, taking some blood samples for the vascular experiment, which looks to determine the impact of long-duration space flights on the blood vessels of astronauts, and also develop any potential countermeasures. Expedition 37 Commander Fyodor Yurchikhin doing a lot of maintenance work throughout the Russian segment this week. Back on Monday, he was inspecting a number of the Russian controlling laptops and computers, and also conducting a comm test of his Soyuz craft. Yurchikhin scheduled to return to Earth coming up on November 10th alongside Luca Parmitano and Karen Nyberg. But on Tuesday, picked up with a lot of his maintenance activities, doing some preventative maintenance on the Zvezda service module's ventilation systems. Also continuing that into Wednesday while also doing a quick study of the veins in his lower extremities for part of a Russian biological experiment. On Thursday, collecting surface samples from inside of Zarya and Zvezda for downlink down to the ground for controllers to keep an eye on the environment of the International Space Station for the crew. And then today, he's doing a cardiovascular evaluation on himself during some exercise on one of the station's stationary cycles, and also prepacking some items again for that upcoming return on his Soyuz craft back down to Earth. Meanwhile, Oleg Kotov spending much of his week preparing for that upcoming November 9th spacewalk, also getting some time in to do some experiment work throughout the week. Back on Tuesday, he was gathering some readings from dosimeters inside of the Russian Matryoshka experiment, which looks to track the radiation dosages that these astronauts are exposed to. On Wednesday, collecting some blood and saliva samples. But then today, on Friday, he's assisting Luca Parmitano in all of the preparation work for the departure of ATV and helping him close out the hatchway to it for one final time. And then the final crew member, Sergei Rozanski, focused on that November 9th spacewalk, but also conducting a few experiments throughout the week. Namely, back on Wednesday, he was participating in the Siner investigation, doing observations of the world's oceans for searching for bioproductive water areas. And then today on Friday, he'll be conducting the BAR experiment, which looks to develop effective ways of determining any depressurization that might happen inside of station modules, basically a safety task for these astronauts and cosmonauts during long-duration space flights on the International Space Station. So again, a busy week saw the departure of one craft, preparation for the departure of another unmanned cargo vehicle, and a lot of work being done on the spacesuits for these astronauts and cosmonauts in preparation for a spacewalk coming up in just about 2 weeks from now.